Hello students, in this class we will study about multilevel inheritance. Okay, first let's see what do you mean by multilevel inheritance. Okay, a multilevel inheritance multilevel inheritance means inheritance technique is performed in more than one level. Means we are in the previous inheritances we are seeing that there are only two levels. Okay, one is your base level and another one is your derived class level or subclass level or base class level. But here we are having multiple levels of inheritance. Means here one type of inheritance, here also one type of inheritance. Okay, so that means a class can also be derived from one class which is already derived from another class. Okay, that means here in this picture, as you can see, B class is derived from A class and the C class is derived from B class. Okay, this is a real life example. It is your grandparent, it is your parent, and this is child. Okay, so here I call it as A is parent or B child, C is your grandchild, as you can clarify it. Okay, let us see an example how we can write this multi-level inheritance or how we can implement this multi-level inheritance in a C++ program. Okay, so here is an example. You can also write it by yourself, but how that in the previous lecture we have studied about single inheritance. That means it is one single inheritance, A, B one single inheritance, and B, C is one single inheritance. Okay, but the calling data members and member functions is different. That means C can call the data members or member functions of B and also the member and data functions of A. Okay, but if we will take it as single inheritance, okay, like A to B and B to C, you cannot call like this. But in the multilevel inheritance, C class object can access the member functions, data members of class A as well as class B. Okay, so let's see an example. Here I am implementing that to be picture. Okay, so here is public. I am declared as public. This is your base function. For this function name I have taken as base function. This is content of base class. Whatever you can write it, or you can calculate the previous example of multiple inheritance. Okay, then this class B function is inherited from A. So as the single inheritance syntax, we are writing that class B, this is your base class, and then access specifier, then your derived class. Okay, sorry, it is your derived class, access specifier, and this is your base class. Then void, this is my child function, and here as C class is derived from base class B, so we have to write it class C and class B like this. But as multiple inheritance, you cannot write class C, class B, comma class A. Okay, you cannot write like this. Okay, if you will write like comma, then it will display the syntax of multiple inheritance. Okay, and this is the program. Okay, now let's go to the main function. We are creating an object of class C. objective class C. And by using this class, you can call each function. This is the function of grandchild, this is the function of child or B class, this is the function of base class or F. Okay, everything you can call, and the output will be first that the content of grandchild, like this, content of grandchild, then content of child function, then content of base function. Okay, you can take any examples of multi-level inheritance, you can write anything, but you have to represent it like this example. It's a simple example I have taken. Okay, you can also implement it in more complex forms. Okay, thank you.